before we came to the hospital to get the resources here, I mean, it was really difficult. I cried a lot. I spent a lot of time off my job. We just didn't know what was wrong with Faith. We just kept getting all the diagnosis, but none of the treatment.
It's really hard because they can't tell you what they need or what is wrong. You just have to try to figure it out. It gets frustrating. Sometimes it gets frustrating for her.
Childhood language disorders are any condition or disorder that puts a child at risk for not achieving the normal process of learning his or her language.
Hello, Mia. Hello.
Babies are born with an amazing capacity to learn their native language.
¿Te gusta? ¿Quieres un libro?
They spend the first year of life listening and playing with their voice, and then they say their first word, and then language pours forth. That happens naturally for most children, but some children don't have that opportunity.
What's up?
What's up?
Because of a condition that may be present at birth, like a cleft palate, or because they have a syndrome like Down syndrome.
Our purpose and goal is to give every child and family that needs assistance the ability to get treatment for childhood language disorders.
The actual story of RiteCare begins with a social worker here at Children's Hospital reaching out to the Masons with a possible request of, can you provide assistance to a family, to a child that needs help?
Wow!
From that beginning, we have spread throughout the 35 states of the Southern jurisdiction and some foreign territories into over 200 centers today.
Well, in this day and age where insurance is very tight and becoming tighter for therapy especially, we have a lot of families that are marginalized in terms of their health care.
Three.
Jump! Jump! So the Scottish Rite Foundation has stepped in with many of these families and gives them that support so that their child has continuous therapy services.
And the thing that I really feel good about is to provide help for people who are hardworking middle class people who would just be overwhelmed with the expense.
Now who wants to go?
Let's go.
When we heard about the services and then you hear about how much the service costs without the grants and the Scottish Rite's grants, I don't know how anybody could pay for it. It could almost be impossible.
Charity, it's one of the tenets of our profession. We have a commitment and an obligation as really as men and as Masons to provide assistance for those that need it.
A dream come true for a speech therapist to have funding to be able to do what you want to do.
Oh, you sure can. Yeah, thanks for asking.
It's really meant a lot to me to have them provide their service for me and my daughter.
One. Two. You caught two fish.
Because I think it's going to bring Isabella a long way, and she'll continue to improve more and more all the time.
What we want to do is to make it easy and financially practicable to provide speech and language services to kids throughout the state of Colorado.
I first came here in 1983, and the only place that a child could get Scottish Rite assistance was at the Children's Hospital in downtown Denver.
Not everyone can travel to Denver. Not everyone can travel even to Colorado Springs or Grand Junction. So it's important to our mission that we continue to establish partnerships in as many geographic locations as possible so that we can provide the services of our RiteCare clinics to as many children as possible.
So we now cover the state from Sterling to La Junta, from Grand Junction to Cortez, and spots in between to help children with language disorders. One of the unique programs that Scottish Rite sponsors to help prevent literacy problems is a program called the Treasure Chest Program.
Hey, Drew.
We provide theme-based tubs to our families. They contain early literacy materials such as books on tape, games, puzzles, things and activities that parents can do with their children at home.
I think it really helps parents understand to work with their kids, even just for a little bit a day.
Oh, look at that. There's big R, and go find little R.
It's so important that we nurture the future generation of speech-language pathologists to serve these children. Childhood language disorders are not going away, but we will find new and better ways to treat them.
The scholarship program is so important to us. We'll have trained, qualified clinicians that can go throughout the state to these clinics and to the children in the communities to provide the services that they need.
The students have very high costs associated with pursuing a graduate education. And so we want to support them in any way we can in order to keep them in Colorado once they graduate.
I'm very grateful to receive the Dwight A. Hamilton Scholarship. The scholarship has really made that possible again to fully focus and fully maximize on all of the academic and clinical opportunities in the program.
I want donors to know that the money that they give to us for the treatment of children with communication challenges is going to that service, whether it's in speech therapy or related services that are provided through our program.
Clean up the bottles and powders.
They need to understand in a powerful way that these children who might otherwise never receive therapy services, that those children have that opportunity now to succeed in life.
You want to tell them what you like to do in school?
Yes.
Okay. Go ahead.
Gym.
Yes.
I know she's two, but you know, two-year-olds, they know that, like, she knows that she's different. Like, to see other kids that are just like her, like, she feels really like she's at home. She can be herself.
Red?
Which one?
Red? Red? Good job.
It's a big change, actually. I mean, she goes to daycare now. I mean, she's a very big, bubbly people person.
I'm working with the best team of people in the world who love their job, who love helping families. I love seeing the children learn, grow, communicate, the joy on the families' faces when their children make great gains. And then working with the Masons, a group of men who truly believe that we are here to help our fellow man. And they believe that from the heart. And that means so much to me to have the privilege of working with them and my colleagues here at the hospital.
It goes beyond simply having a philanthropy, but it goes to the very essence of who we are and what we practice as Masons.
There's no question that what we're doing is going to leave this world a better place.
It's our life's work. The Kaiser Life Foundation is something that we spend our lives supporting and doing. And we reached out to those kids, those young children that need our services. And in doing so, we help them lead meaningful and productive lives.